balayer les amours avec leur trémolo, balayer pour toujours. Je repars à zéro.
December 1915, in a working neighborhood of Paris. The birth of Edith Giovanna Gassion, the future songbird Edith Piaf.
This is the house where Edith's parents lived. Legend has it that she was actually born here on the steps of the building. But when you do the research, you find she was born in a much less interesting place, the maternity ward of the Thénon Hospital, not far from here. But the story is so appealing that it endures.
All but abandoned by her parents during a troubled childhood, the young Edith began earning a living singing on street corners. At just 17, she gave birth to a baby girl who died of meningitis 2 years later. In 1936, she was discovered by a nightclub owner who nicknamed her La Môme Piaf, or Little Sparrow. That new moniker marked the beginning of her climb to stardom.
Starting in the years 1937, 38 to 41, Piaf began doing big tours, then some theater, including a piece by Jean Cocteau, and eventually film. Edith also launched the careers of several men in her life, notably Yves Montand, who was perhaps her greatest discovery.
But her greatest love was the boxer Marcel Cerdan, with whom she had a high-profile affair. His death in a plane crash in 1949 sparked a deep depression and downward spiral for Piaf. She was seriously injured in a number of near-fatal car accidents and battled drug and alcohol abuse. While she privately struggled, her career was booming. Nearly two decades after La Vie en Rose, she hit gold again with I Regret Nothing and a series of concerts at the Olympia in Paris.
Si vous étiez obligé d'arrêter de chanter, qu'est-ce qui se passerait?
Oh, je vais dire un mot très horrible, très, très horrible, mais je crois que je me suis dit ça.
Living and dying for song, that's the legacy of Edith Piaf. She died of liver cancer in 1963 at the age of 47 in her villa in the south of France. Her body was buried in the Père Lachaise Cemetery in her hometown, Paris. Her tombstone, a reminder of her talent and contributions to French music.